special guest speaker, and she's going to speak for a few moments before we bring up our next panel. And I want to introduce Sheila Fejeran. Sheila Fejeran is one of my true mentors. She's an extraordinary, extraordinary woman. And I have her brief bio here, and I wanted to read it because I think it does a little more justice. It says, Sheila Fejeran started dreaming and designing homes as a child, sketching out floor plans in her school notebooks. With this love of homes and construction, Sheila originally began her career in the new home sales business, working to design floor plans and custom homes for some of the top builders in the Metroplex, selling between 50 and 100 homes a year. You're out of Dallas, right? With a double major in speech communications and radio, television, and film, she understands the importance and power of marketing. She worked for almost a decade for radio stations in the Midwest and East Coast as a sales manager. Before joining EXP, Sheila was the managing broker and VP of a boutique brokerage. I can get that word. Boutique brokerage, and had built up to 12 offices in 4 states with 15 REO contracts and the HUD contract. Sheila and her team of 40 agents sold over 6,000 homes together over the course of 7 years. After joining EXP, Sheila ran a team and was personally selling 100 homes a year. Last year, she moved to a full-time focus on agent attraction and supporting her team, which includes her favorite superstar, Brent Gove. Sheila has been at EXP for 4.5 years and has a team of almost 11,000 agents around the world. So everybody, well, please welcome my very good friend, Sheila Fejeran.
That's my girl.
Good morning. Okay, so normally, I'm going to move this. Normally when I speak, I have about a month to prepare. And I usually pray a lot about what I'm going to speak about because I like to write things out. I'm one of those weird planning people and like to kind of have it all laid out of exactly what I'm going to say. But Marguerite decided that she wanted this to be raw and real, is what she said. So she said, you're not allowed to have a script. You're not allowed to use a PowerPoint. You're not allowed to show a video. She wouldn't even share with us, for those people on the panel who have been texting and calling her nonstop, she wouldn't even tell us the questions she was going to ask because she really wanted to make sure that it was just real. So, now I can't speak for the other speakers who are going to be up here today, but for me, this was super stressful because I'm used to having everything planned out. And so last night we're sitting, Elizabeth got in late, her flight got delayed, and we're sitting at the hotel last night, and they know me very well. And they were cutting up, man. They were cracking up, joking with me about the fact that I didn't have a chance to pray about this. And they said, girl, man, you better get busy. You got like 3 hours tomorrow morning to pray to get ready for what you're going to say. And so that's what I did. I got up at 4 this morning and started praying. And what really hit my heart were two things that I was not at all expecting to hit my heart, but because of Miss Marguerite forcing us into this situation, the two feelings that came up for me were vulnerability and uncomfortability. And so that's what I want to talk about today. And the only thing I knew is that Marguerite wanted me to speak before the panel of moms. So I knew I was going to be on that panel, and I am a single mom, like some of the women that had mentioned that were up here. And she said, I want to make sure you talk about being a single mom, running a business, building a business, being successful, all that stuff. So there is a video that I didn't get to play, but I want to have you guys look up. It was from a 1999 Super Bowl commercial that I want you to look up. And it was for Monster.com. And it was a tongue-in-cheek kind of commercial, very... Yeah, tongue-in-cheek's the easiest way to describe it. It's called When I Grow Up. And, you know, we've all heard people say, or we've said to people, you know, what do you want to be when you grow up, right? And so this commercial is, I want you to visualize kids. With everything I'm going to say, I want you to imagine just different kids popping up on the screen saying what I'm getting ready to say. So when I grow up, I want to file all day. I want to climb my way to middle management. I want to be replaced on a whim. I want to have a brown nose. I want to be a yes man, a yes woman. Yes, sir, coming, sir. I'll do anything for a raise, sir. When I grow up, I want to be underappreciated and be paid less for doing the same job. Now, who in the world would ever want to say that, right? Nobody. Nobody wants to be average. And being a leader, which is what this is all about, you know, top women in leadership. Being a leader doesn't mean you're superhuman. It doesn't mean you have all the answers. It doesn't mean you always know how to get there or what you're going to do. But the truth is, when we get honest with ourselves, everybody wants opportunity, right? Everybody wants possibility. Everyone wants a mission. And we all want to do something that matters. Are you guys in agreement with me? Don't you guys want to do something that matters, right? And it's not just even about making more money. Because it's about what will that money do for you when you make more money. And those of us who are brokers, we have a joke that we're broker than everybody else. Because you realize the more money you make, the less money you actually make. It's like, how does that work? You wind up having bills to pay, offices to run, staffs to hire, systems to buy. The government always has their hand in your pocket. And so you wind up actually making less, even though you're making more. Or you spend it like what Marguerite said. So John Maxwell has a quote. He says, leaders become great, not because of their power, but because of their ability to empower others. And I think it was really, you know, I always look at stuff like this is a God thing. Like Marguerite sharing in the beginning that there's so many people that were texting, calling her, whatever, even from the panel, that are insecure, that are nervous, that feel less than, that feel unworthy, that don't feel like they can compete or that I'm not as good as. And really becoming a leader, it isn't about you having it all figured out. It's really about focusing on your purpose of helping everybody else achieve their goals and their potential. And then through that, somehow, magically, you become a leader. And I think of it, because the whole mom thing that we're getting ready to do, I think of being a leader a lot like being a mom. Because you want the best for them, right? You have their best interest at heart. You fight for them, you stand up for them, you go to bat for them. And as a mom, you do everything in your power to help your children succeed. You dream for them, right? And so your goal is to help them grow up to become self-sufficient, responsible human beings that are full of integrity and are respectful and are just good people. And that's really the same thing when you're a team leader or when you're a broker or when you're a leader in the real estate industry. And I think that's important to understand with what I'm getting ready to share with you. Because I'm going to go back to what I started with, about those two little feelings that Marguerite brought up in me. Whew. Now I brought tissue just in case I cry, so just kind of warning you, I'm a crier. So we're going to get vulnerable. And we're going to get a little uncomfortable here for a minute. And for the men, you can hold your ears, you can leave the room, whatever you feel comfortable with, but I'm just going to be raw and real with you guys, okay? The topic for today is about top women in real estate. And we've all been to conferences, and we've all gotten great information, and we hear great speakers, and we get inspired. We learn how to farm. We learn how to do scripts. We learn how to run teams. We learn how to be a CEO. We learn how to do a lot of things. And we do become successful because of doing those things. And a lot of us have made a lot of money doing those things. But as a mom, especially as a single mom, and as a woman, there are so many things going on that we don't talk about at conferences. And we all understand that it's just part of life that we have to deal with. Because not only are we meant to do what it takes to be successful in our business, but most of us have to do dishes. We have to clean the house, do the grocery shopping, do the cooking, drive the kids to school, to band, to practice, to sporting events, to the doctors. We have to run the household, pay the bills. We're also expected to have our nails done, our hair done, and our makeup done. Because, of course, people would gasp if we didn't, like, come put all together, right? And it's like we're supposed to look like Barbie and be a wife, like Leave It to Beaver, but build a business like Tony Robbins. And that, let's not forget what we're supposed to be in the bedroom, right? So I think all the women in here are laughing because they know it's true. And, I mean, think about it, guys. It's like, dang. Is it any wonder that how in the world do we even run a successful business? Seriously. And as if that's not enough on your plate, we have a lot of other issues as women that we're dealing with. And so again, Marguerite said raw and real, so I'm going to be raw and real. Oh, ladies, we have a lot of issues. We have issues that people don't talk about. We have issues that make people uncomfortable, and we have issues that affect every part of our lives and our businesses. And I can tell you from personal experience that if you don't deal with them, they will catch up with you, and they can make you physically ill and mentally ill. And I believe that the reason why we have such high rates of depression, suicide, and mental illness is because we're not talking about our issues. So what do I mean by this? So when I look at groups of women like this, and I'm gonna get real, you guys ready for this? The thought that pops into my mind is that 1 in 3 girls are sexually abused before they're 18. Nearly 1 in 5 women have experienced or had attempted rape during their lifetime. Every 68 seconds in America, someone is sexually assaulted. There are 42 million survivors of child sexual abuse living in the U.S. today. 30% of sexual abuse is not even reported. 1 in 3 women have experienced some form of physical violence by an intimate partner. And according to statistics, 1 in 5 college women have been verbally abused by a partner. And why is this important? Because abuse can cause many chronic health problems, heart problems, high blood pressure, digestive problems. Women who are abused are more likely to develop depression, anxiety, eating disorders, and women also who are abused misuse alcohol and drugs as a way to cope. So I am the statistic. I have had so much more than even those things that I just listed happen to me at the hands of other people. So much stuff that I actually couldn't remember anything before the age of 16. And it took many years of therapy and a lot of work for things to start coming out that had happened to me. And this is the first time I have ever spoken publicly. Wow. about these topics. So thank you, Marguerite, for pushing me out of my comfort zone to discuss vulnerability and being uncomfortable. And these things are important, ladies, because when you're a woman and an agent, you have to think about things that other people don't talk about. You have to actually think about, who are you meeting at the house today? Do you go in the house with them? Do you have a concealed carry license? Are you prepared to use it and to kill them? That's what they teach you in a concealed carry license class. Do you have pepper spray or another form of defense? So we're dealing with raising a family and all the craziness that I mentioned. And now we're having to worry about staying safe just to do our jobs. And are we going to live after the showing? I mean, it's crazy when you really start being honest about what we deal with. And why am I bringing this up? I'm bringing it up because for you to be a top successful agent, you have to take care of yourself. You have to take care of your heart and your mind. You have to heal the wounds from the past and the hurts so that they don't take a toll on your body and on your life now. And that was one of the biggest things that I did for myself over the years. In Psychiatry 101, that teaches that every problem boils down to us choosing to believe one of three lies about ourselves. And again, it's a God thing. Marguerite mentioned some of that in her speech. We had no clue what anybody was saying. You're going to either believe one of these three things. I am helpless. I am worthless. Or I'm unlovable. Everything boils down to your motivation to one of those three things. So I've actually spent the last few years studying topics like shame. I'm writing a book called Forgive and Forget, that it's not enough to just learn to forgive people. You actually have to move through the process of learning how to forget what they did to you. I've been studying what it means to be worthy, what it means to be loved, and really praying to have freedom from the demons that have haunted me through my life because of what I've been through. And you're going to have to do the same thing, because you can't get through the other side and have the success and the freedom and all of the things you really want until you deal with yourself. And a lot of dealing with yourself means dealing with the people who hurt you in the past. And yes, you do have to do the work. You do have to make the phone calls. You do have to go on the appointments. You do have to do all the other things that you learn in conferences normally that you're taught to do to be successful. So you still have to keep doing the actions of juggling your schedule like the ladies talked about. And one little hint to the two ladies that talked about driving so much. One of the biggest things that changed my business is I hired a full-time driver. So someone used to drive me every day. I would spend 4 hours a day in the car. I was selling 100 homes a year by myself without my team. And so as you can imagine, single mother dealing with all the things I'm dealing with, it's a little busy. So one of the biggest things I did was hire a driver. And what we would do is she would drive me. I would be in the back of the vehicle with a plug for my computer. I had my own desk. I would literally just work nonstop while we were going to appointments so that I could double my business and keep growing. And eventually, over the course of time, I taught her how to be an assistant. So then I doubled down. So she would drive me to the appointments, and I had a separate computer that she would work on while I was in the appointment getting the listing. And then I'd get back in the car and keep working. So just a hint for those two ladies that mentioned drivers. The biggest thing about growing in your business is leverage. That needs to be your favorite word, because you have to learn how to leverage. And as a new young agent or a rising star agent, it's very scary to spend money. It's very scary to step out on a limb and try new things. So I hired my first assistant in the Philippines because I was too scared to hire somebody in town. And then I hired a second person in the Philippines, and then a third, and then a fourth. And I had four full-time people in the Philippines running my entire company for me. And then I hired the driver. So literally, I just kept doubling down, leverage, in order to continue growing my company. And it's a lot to manage, right? It's a lot to manage. So what I want to encourage you with today, if you don't remember anything else that I say, is leverage. And I encourage you to be vulnerable and surround yourself with people that can be honest with you and that you can be honest with about what you're going through, about what you've been through, that you can allow them to empower you as you work to empower them, and get uncomfortable and push yourself to do things that it's going to take you not necessarily where you want to go, but it's going to take you where you ought to go or where you ought to be. Because, ladies, you are able, you are lovable, and you are worthy. God bless.